greetings. I want to document for you the next in a long list of reasons to reject Islam. Surah 2:106. Any message which we annul or consign to oblivion, we replace with a better or a similar one. Nothing of our revelation, even a single verse, do we abrogate or cause to be forgotten, but we bring in place one better or the like thereof. Whatever communications we abrogate or cause to be forgotten, we bring one better than it or like it. None of our revelations do we abrogate or cause to be forgotten, but we substitute something better or similar. The reason to reject Islam is abrogation. As you can see from these translations of the Quran itself claims that parts of it are forgotten. And more importantly than that, the Quran seems to accuse Allah of being the one to make words be forgotten. Evidently, even Allah thinks his words are forgettable. And take a moment and think about the order in which this is stated. Allah replaces his forgotten passage with something better or similar. The order is important because it says something. It's as if you see the mind of the author at work. If Allah replaced it, the new revelation must be better. Yeah, that sounds good. But wait, wasn't my revelation perfect and clear to begin with? So how could my new revelation be better? Well, it would have to be as good as my first revelation, wouldn't it? Oh yeah, that's good, that's good. It would at least be as good as the original. By Allah, I'm so smart. At least it's better than a man could write. By Allah, I have to remember that. That sounds clever. Hey, Jibril, over here. Write this down. Replace better or at least similar. I don't care how you think it sounds. By Allah, Allah says write it down. Yeah, better or at least as good. Well, at least much better than a man. Oh, okay. I challenge a man to try. You see, the author of the Quran applied rationalization to his authorship. And it's pretty obvious how the author thought as he made things up. If you are a Muslim, this begs some troubling questions. Isn't the Quran supposed to be the timeless and eternal word of your Allah? Think about the fable of the creation of the Quran. Okay, this video is not about the inconsistencies in the stories of how the Quran was created. You see, Islam cannot even say if the Quran has always existed, or is partner to Allah, or if Allah wrote it at some later time. That is perhaps a topic I'll get into later, or in another video. For the sake of this video and this analysis, let's assume... Okay, I know what happens to you when you assume, but let's assume, let's imagine, let's play along with the fairy tales. Let's imagine Allah is a deity and Allah has his perfect word. Think about what those two words mean. If you are in school and you are taking a test, and you have every answer correct, perfect. Given the chance to change answers, which ones do you change? Think about it. You would not change anything. Your test is perfect. This is what perfect means, brother. It means there is nothing wrong with it. And that begs a question. How could the original Quran have been perfect if Allah needed to abrogate parts of it? And that begs a question. How much of the original Quran did Allah have to abrogate? You see, you and I have no way of knowing, because Allah made everyone forget the imperfect original Quran. If we abrogate a verse or cause it to be forgotten, we will replace it by a better one or one similar to it. Allah caused parts to be forgotten. They question, O Muhammad, the wisdom of abrogation in certain circumstances. None of our revelations or signs, secondary in character, do we terminate, but we replace it with a better or equivalent substitute. That's the Al-Muntakab translation of the Quran. Al seems to be a little more long-winded. But that begs a question. If Allah is writing or creating this Quran, and Allah seems to know that the changes in the Quran are being challenged, so much so that Allah must reveal this rationalization for changes, why didn't the all-knowing Allah simply know this before he started revealing it to Muhammad? He would have saved himself shame and embarrassment if he had just waited to release the final correct version of the Quran. You know, no Quran 2.0. It would be so much more impressive of Allah if he had just gotten it right the first time. I mean, for crying out loud, there was a man, a composer named Bach, who once improvised a three-part fugue on a theme King Frederick gave him on a challenge. Now if a man, howbeit a very gifted man, can make up on the fly a fugue with three voices, and do it on the spot in real time, the time of the performance, don't you think a deity could, in the infinite past, have enough time to get it right before he begins to reveal his message? It is a troubling thing, my friend, that your Allah could not figure it out in advance, and then had to reveal what I can only call an excuse to cover a problem. Every aspect of this surah speaks to me of a story. There once was a man, and this man had a son. This man also had a gambling problem. And because this man would lose, he one day began to sell his son's things to cover his gambling losses. Well, the son did not notice at first. A few trinkets and books went missing. But one day, the boy noticed his train set was missing. And the day after that, his bicycle was missing. And in tears, he went to his father and said, "I noticed things you had given me were disappearing, Father. So I watched, and then I saw that it was you taking my things away." "Why, Father? Why are you taking my things? The things you said were gifts to me." And the father was very embarrassed for having been found out. So he did what was his nature to do. He lied. He had been caught stealing to cover his gambling losses. So he quickly made up a good-sounding lie. "Oh yes, son, those were gifts to you. But I did not see you with them all the time. So I decided to give them to others who would appreciate them more. But do you not know that whatever gift I cause to be taken away or forgotten, I will replace it with a toy of equal or greater value? Do you not know I have power to get you new toys?" Let that just sink in for a moment. The whole surah excusing abrogation, no, the whole stinking concept of abrogation, reeks of the stench of a dishonest man being caught in a lie, and quickly making up another lie to excuse getting caught. So when Muhammad began to have enough of a history that people could begin to compare and consider his whole revelation, some no doubt noticed changes from year to year, and they began to ask about the contradictions. So that which happened so often in Muhammad's career happened again. He conveniently had a new revelation that fixed the problems caused by the old set of revelations. Teaching about alcohol is one of the glaring examples. Surah 443, "O you who have attained faith, do not attempt to pray while you are in a state of drunkenness, but wait until you know what you are saying." Think about that. The passage accepts that drunkenness exists and will continue to exist. It does not say, until you learn later that being drunk is bad. And that begs a question. How come Allah starts his eternal Quran with the concept Muslims will be drunk? This whole concept of abrogation screams that the Quran was conveniently concocted on the fly. And that is why abrogation is a reason to reject Islam. The very existence of abrogation and the inclusion in the Quran itself as an excuse more or less proves that the Quran was not a completed work before Muhammad began to reveal it. But I understand those who call themselves Muslim must seek to look at the Quran with the eyes of a child looking at their mother. You must look with loving and forgiving eyes, seeing past all the faults and problems. You must look past your father who stole your gifts, and when confronted, lied and said he was planning to replace them. There was never any plan to replace them until he was caught. And then pure shame made him cover up his sin with another tale. One that he would have to make good on to save face. Well, the author of the Quran was caught changing parts and losing parts of his book. For whatever sign we change or eliminate or cause to recede into oblivion. So much for the eternal Quran being complete and entire. And that is why this is reason number 11, to reject the Quran and reject Islam. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.